So, work hard, play hard, right? Time to enjoy a little relaxation to make sure that I can still dial in and really hit the ground running and do things the way I need to. Let's talk about the punctuation. Hey, yo, what's up, tribe? Welcome to the punctuation. This is a video that I will do every time I end a specific series of videos, something to put a comma, a pause, a period, an exclamation point on the set of videos that I just finished. In case of what I just did, most of my videos were basically practicing, getting ready for actually having a good long-term cadence. So I hope you enjoyed them. There may be some changes that I'll make. I'm going to take maybe a week or two off while I rethink some of my strategies. But generally speaking, you'll see a lot more professional development coming on in the next couple of weeks, months, and into the year. In the meantime, let me talk about this island, because let me tell you, tribe, it is beautiful here. If you ever think about coming, I highly encourage it. Holbox, Mexico is off the Yucatan Peninsula, and it takes about 2 hours to get here from the Cancun airport. So you fly into Cancun, and you'll take either a shuttle or a private taxi cab. Cost me about $100, 2,000 Mexican pesos to get here. Then you take a ferry from Chiquilla over to the actual island. And actually, I was able to walk to my hotel, which, as you can see, is right by the beach. This is a great island. There's plenty of little shopping places that you can go, that you can buy trinkets, that you can buy tchotchkes. It is great. There's also some fantastic food. I had a lobster egg benedict for breakfast, which doesn't sound very Mexican, but lobster is a thing on this island. Plenty of tacos, fajitas, you know, all the standard Mexican fare, but I actually encourage you to go outside the box on this. They actually have a lot of ceviche on this island, which is a Peruvian dish, so you can enjoy that. Either way, this is definitely a place that I would encourage you to visit. There are some caveats about coming here, though. One thing that is important to note is that, like the rumor is, you don't actually want to drink the water. You use it for bathing and whatnot, but you want to make sure you're using bottled water or filtered water in some way, shape, or form to ensure that you're not going to mess up your gut, because their water systems are different here. The people are absolutely friendly. On Holbox, most, if not all, speak English in some level of proficiency, much better than Americans when it comes to speaking other languages, right? However, if you do make an effort to speak Spanish, they will definitely appreciate that. One thing I have noticed is that often when I open my mouth and I speak Spanish, they'll reply to me in English. I don't know what that means. But generally still, very friendly individuals here on the island.
One aspect of this island that I found particularly gorgeous are the sunsets, which you can see is a thing here. Sun went down probably around 6:30, 7 o'clock on the island, and everyone, wherever, would just collect to enjoy this spectacle. Another thing you can do on this island is horseback riding. I caught these guys getting ready to set up during one of my morning runs. Now, you might make a friend on the island. There are lots of dogs, not necessarily stray, that just kind of run about. Since there's no cars allowed on the island, it's pretty safe for them. This guy, obviously, was super friendly, but what you'll see is that most of them, they pretty much just lie around and watch you go past. Unless you have food, they'll probably ignore you.
An interesting little fact about the island is because it's on a preserve, there are no cars allowed on the island unless they're specifically doing deliveries or utilitarian. So, to get around the island, what many people will use are these golf carts that you may have just seen. There's plenty of golf cart taxis. They're gas-powered, not electric-powered, so very interesting. In addition to that,
you'll see that the streets are not really paved. And when I asked someone about that, they said, no, that's deliberate. They don't want paved streets. They like how this particularly packed material is, and it's part of their culture. It's part of their island. One thing that you have to watch out for, though, is if it's rainy, your shoes are probably not going to come out of it clean and easy. Still, it just really helps underscore how quaint and how nice this island is.
Now, you'll want to dress appropriately, and the hat is obviously not just because I'm bald, but the sun is pretty strong on the face, so the hat will keep it off. If you forgot your hat, not a problem. You'll probably bump into someone who happens to be selling one along the beach or at one of the many, many, many shops. So if you're looking for a place to go, hopefully some of my video will help you consider Holbox Island. That's not the only great place in Mexico, just a place that I happen to record and happen to go for this particular little micro vacation. All right, Tribe. Hey, thanks for checking this video out. It's something a little different. But regardless, remember that it is important to take that pause, important to sharpen your saw, important to taper, relax, refresh, however you're looking for, however you want to look at it. But still, I hope you're better today than you were yesterday, and I'm looking forward to you being better tomorrow than you were today. Take care.